was so much controversy about SC400 versus SC430. This car would whoop it. Maybe in the street, I don't know. These cars put out a decent amount of torque. Handling, I don't know. I haven't taken this out on the back roads through experience much. But I know back in the day when these cars were new, back like 2006, even with the HR somewhere around the 2007, 2008, these dudes were racing G35s and, you know, they would just deflate their tires down to like 35, 30 PSI for better traction. And of course, they would get off them run flats. So if you do get an SC430, first thing you do is get off them run flats. It makes a world's difference. Sweet. And we got this new driveway right here that's super easy to get into. Let me crawl into this bad boy right here. Ooh, it's like just a little bit. This thing's like stupid low. And we'll see what I'm working with. I have no clue where my front's at in this car, so sorry about the bad job, guys. Driving job. Herf VQ life. This is what we're working with today, guys. Needs a wash. I gotta check the coilovers, all that good stuff. Let's do it.
...2002 Lexus SC430 in for a wash and clean. Lowered on case for suspension. And then on top of that, we got some Diablo wheels. Bryson, don't kill me. But right now, SC's undergoing some work. I can't show y'all yet. Gotta clean this and finish up my project. You can kind of see the front a little bit, but we'll leave that for another day. So let's get into this. Needs to be washed. The battery is dead. So I'm just gonna let it run while the whole thing. So we've got the white pearl, I guess like a newer version of DWP. I don't know the paint codes off the top of my head. Interior needs some love, which I have. I'll go over that in a second. Let me pop the trunk. So interior is kind of good to go. Armrest, and then we got the two front seats here, I believe, to be reupholstered. Now, I know my reupholstering videos or something related to seats or fixing them aren't that popular, so if you guys want to see that, comment below and I'll go ahead and tackle the SC430 seats, reupholstering those on my YouTube video. All right, so let's start with this, everybody. Step one, rinse the car down. That way you can spray off any contaminants. Step one, the easy stuff to come off. I think this is going to take a little bit of love. Again, I'm skipping the wheels. You want it as clean as possible. Now let's talk about the Lexus SC430. A lot of people say it's ugly. I think it was a nice design for its time. It was really groundbreaking just how the Lexus SC300-400 was. The problem with this one was people were really stuck on the third generation, which as you know is the Z31, Z30. Lexus SC or Toyota Soar. This was a Toyota Soar up until 2006. A lot of you Toyota guys keep forgetting that Toyota is really strong compared to the big three. And what I mean by the big three is Honda, Toyota, and Nissan. Lexus is the only international company that can be bought in Japan. Now, when I was in Japan, Infiniti did not exist in Japan. Acura does not exist in Japan. So why you boys with your Celsiors, Altezas, and Soars always complaining, oh, Toyota did this better. Lexus is a flex for the whole brand of Toyota as is. So stop your bickering. Like I said, there's no Acura in Japan and there's no Honda. I'm sorry, no Acura and there's no Infiniti in Japan, which is why, what you guys get confused on, the G35 is a Skyline, an NA rear-wheel drive, GT or GTS, with the turbo ones now, GTST, or the 400R as they call it. So when this car changed over to SC430, it's kind of like the opposite here. With branding, a lot of the guys, you know, they find the Lexus emblems, they want the USDM style, kind of how we like the JDM style. In a sense, You know, this is a grown-up SC400. Now, what people fail to realize when it comes to the Toyota Lexus brand is that, you know, the Soar had a 3.0 GT and GTS package, which was a 2JZ GE. The 1JZ was so lame that the Soar did not even come with a 1JZ GE for the base model. Let's just leave it at that. Now, when you come to this, this is, again, successor to the SC400. How it drives, I like it. It has that same girthy growl to it, very deep, all that good stuff. Nice driving car.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's start with the elephant in the room. As we all may or may not know, this vehicle was on Top Gear, reviewed by Jeremy Clarkson versus, I think it was, a Hyundai Genesis when it was new, the Genesis Coupe. So, to me, I take things with a grain of salt. Yes, it may be the worst car in the world to him, but you have to understand, when it came to the Toyota Soar or the Lexus SC, from a manufacturer standpoint, this is not a race car or a sporty car as Jeremy expected. What I mean by that is, if you look at the literature from the marketing team through Toyota or even Lexus, Toyota called this vehicle the Eternal Jewel, and you don't make a car and give it that kind of nickname if you don't want it to last forever or, you know, have some sort of goal and plan. On top of that, this thing was marketed as a Super Gran Turismo, a Super GT car. I don't mean Super GT as in GT 300 or 500, which it did compete in. I mean as in a Super Grand Tour, to where if you want to hop in, let's say this car from, you know, San Diego, California, and drive all the way over to, you know, Pennsylvania, Maine, or Quebec, or something like that, Toronto, you could do so comfortably. That's what it is to accomplish. Also, when it came to commercial ads for the Lexus, you would see a middle-aged guy, probably late 30s to, I would, you know, maybe late 40s at the most, and there would be a bunch of older gentlemen wanting to hitchhike a ride. It was toward the upscale, older, more mature clients, which I think this has. Speaking of that, with the mature clients, that also goes into hand with, you know, the fact that this does not have that Supra stigma to it, which I love, because anything with the 2J in it, because America didn't get much, let's say, variety when it came to a 1J or 2JZ GTE. You know, oh, look at my four-door Supra. You look at YouTube videos or people on Instagram or Facebook, or even comparing their SC or Soars to Supras, like, you got to realize this car is its own thing. I can't find the translation. It was a pretty bad translation, but my wife helped me clean it up. But the project, the idea of the Supra then gave birth to the Soar. And from there, I guess you could say, like, the Soar or SE is like Proto Man, and then the Supra is like Zero. If you're familiar with Mega Man, Proto Man was like thing to start with. I mean, he can't do much, but he's still pretty awesome and can hold his own. Whereas, of course, Zero is the OP sporty, hey, look at me, I got a sword, blah blah blah, and some hair. So that's what I like about this car. Also, you guys should be thankful, because with this car being a 2002, imagine if there was a Mark V Supra. It would have been part of this and or based off of Celica. What you guys fail to realize is Supra is always based off of another car. And if it was off Soar again, it would be based off this car. So that's pretty much it. As in comparison to the Supra or anything else, like, this is a nice Grand Tour car. It's one of few that looks the way it is, the way it does. The brand is, the image is only shared with the Solara, I guess you could say, if you guys are familiar with those Solaras with a similar body style. And to me, that's kind of like watering down the Lexus look when you have a, you know, a Toyota that looks like it, kind of how the Altima Coupe just basically devalued a G35 in a sense. And to me, I think what they could have done in 2006 to 2010 to bring this car some spirit and revitalize sales was not just 97 plus it. And what I mean by that, in 2006 to 2010, is, you know, they got upgrades to the headlights, the taillights, they got a 6-speed automatic transmission versus a 5-speed On top of that, the interior wasn't handmade anymore. It was more machine-based, but they also got different color combos that we didn't get. And then you have your Pebble Beach, which is like your 99 to 2000 SC400s, where it's just, those are the holy grail in-game everything, where you've got the alabaster interior, the red and everything. So, but yeah, when it comes to this car, I think it looks great. Design was built off of, the designers, it was in Calty, but the designers from Calty went to the French Riviera, which I find kind of ironic, because the Buick Riviera, if you guys are familiar with that old school commercial, you could find it on YouTube. It was Buick Riviera versus SC300, I think it was, or SC400, to where the person at Buick was really conning on the Lexus SC400 so hard because, you know, it was outselling the Buick. I mean, that Buick Riviera was a big car for its time too, and you know, those have kind of grown on me, but I think they were wrong wheel drive or something like that, or underpowered, one of the two. As for sales with this car, it kind of started out like every Toyota or Lexus coupe. In the first, you know, 2.5 years, I guess you could say, it, you know, they sell more than what Lexus or Toyota was expecting. And then towards the end of its life, due to no refreshes or anything, this car lasted probably about another 8 years, just like the previous generation did. And you know, you'll see a lot of older ladies with a white one that's super clean, low miles, because if you guys remember, maybe about like 10-12, you know, probably about like 10 years ago, you would see like a 97 plus white SC, and it's just some older lady just driving it, chilling, you know. But with this, I would say in comparison to the SC300 or 400, I really like the cup holder, which I think I posted a video about it later. But let me tell you, man, that cup holder in this is in a nice place to where it's not in the way. I mean, between the SC300, SC400, I'm sorry, between SC400, LC500, and SC430, this has the best place and usable cup holder between all of them. Another thing I like about this car, if you look at the bottom near the tailpipes, it has an external reverse light. And if you're familiar with the SOAR, every generation it skips of what vehicle has external reverse lights. So I think Z10 had external reverse lights. No. Z10 SOAR had the reverse lights built into the taillights. And then Z20 had taillights that were external, not inside the taillights. And then Z30, which is the SC300, had internal taillights. I'm sorry, internal reverse lights on the taillights. SC430 takes them back out, and then LC500 continues that tradition with an external as well. So from 430 to 500, it will then jump to there. Now, plugging in the LC500 to the SC chassis, they're both flagship cars. They both put shockwaves in the industry, in a sense, of their design. You know, they were both really, really praised, and you could tell just the whole vibes of them making the LC500 that's what they were doing with the overall SC4 and SC430 back in the day. I do like how the door is more curved and the side skirt kind of goes up a little bit higher towards the quarter panel versus our car. It has a little bit more shape to it. Ours is kind of just very, it's round, but everything else is just bland, straight. I know simple is always best, but right here you can see me pointing out like the curves. What I'm doing is comparing, there's a certain line right there. You see where my hands are pointing right there? That's where our windowsill would be. And that same shape of how the SC is round continues onto this car right here. So if you look and squint your eyes a certain angle, you can see the same shapes. But go back to what they were saying about how to bring more life into this in 2006. Is I think what they should have done was when F Sport and F did a thing, they should have made an F Sport version of this, a 350, because I believe the 3.5 liter made more horsepower than this 4.3 V8, whereas this V8 made more torque than the V6. So I think they could have personally made a beefed up manual beyond the AR54, I think it is, AR54 transmission they use in the IS or the Tacoma, and then made it hard top, which would have then changed the proportions of this car, you know, and gave it a different update and hard top. That would have really, really brought it to life, and usable back seats would have been great, man. Now, when it comes to aftermarket potential with these cars, whether it's racing or street, it has the potential to do so. For Formula Drift, Daigo Saito put a 2JZ GTE in one, and he literally drifted around with the top down. Toms had one for GT500, and I think there was an Ineos one as well. So the Petronas car, if you guys remember that one, that was the biggest heavy hitter. And the coolest thing about the SC430 on the track that the Super or even SC400 can't touch is when it came to Super GT500 class, it took home some awards. Whereas the Supra that was inserted inside of GT300 was a lower class, and they wanted an amidship car, which is why they made it a 3S GTE power. They took out the 2J because it's so front heavy, and with the balance ratio, a 3S GTE and the Supra just dominated the track. So with this car as is, it has a higher standard as well versus, I would say, the Supra and the SC400 before it when it comes to brand name feats. What else is it? I think in 2010, yeah, 2010 Autobox Super GT Fuji Speedway won as well. And like I said, they've done feats as is and a three, and they use a 3.4 liter V8 as well. So different applications it's done it. Now, one of my buddies, I'll post it up right here, Romeo Rones, he has a spindle grill drop one, looks really nice. I'll post it up right here. So overall with this vehicle, what do I think? Should you get one? Yes. It's one of the vehicles that can look good done up. You can literally have this vehicle on some nice wheels on, you know, H&R Springs or whatever, dropped and roll up to your reunion and be like, hey, I made it kind of thing, and still look successful. I would say the cons of this vehicle is going to be the run flats, number one. As soon as you change those out, and if you can afford to lose cargo space, I think there's an accessory you can get to replace the, to place your spare tire in the back that still accommodates the hardtop going down. Secondary con, if you're coming from an SC400, I would say is overall cargo space. It's just basically a two-seater at this point. The rear seats, they're faced literally 90 degrees vertical for backing, and you have no leg space, so amputee patients and kids under 9 will fit perfectly in the back. Another downside to this would be trunk cargo space as well, along with interior. Sorry, I had to split that up. My daughter was acting up. But there's literally no trunk room. And when the top is up, you have to have like this little, you know how you pull your shades out and they retract? There's something like this in the back where that has to be pulled out to where, you know, the hard top can actually move. So, I mean, golf clubs, all that good stuff. Yeah, you'll be fine. I would say another con would be how expensive everything for this car still is. You know, you can go to the junkyard and find some SC300, 400 parts, or parts are kind of getting expensive through Carlos. With this, I mean, other than dealer, there's not too many spare parts floating around. You know, thankfully, all the side skirts are the same from all years. I mean, even with the front bumper, there's barely a difference in fog lights, all that good stuff, to where you might as well go aftermarket at that point. Headlights are pricey. I think you got to change like the whole ballast and all that stuff in later years. The 2006 models that I spoke of, which are, like I said, the 97 plus of the SC400, those LED tails, I think once they go out, they're pretty much toast. You have to replace them, from what I've been seeing on the 430 Facebook section. But other than that, I mean, if you can afford, not just buy one, but afford one, and what I mean by afford one is own one and be able to take care of it, you know, definitely get it. 3UZ, you know, it's non-interference of the timing belt, all that good stuff, and it sounds great. It's a pusher. I would say first things first is work on your suspension with this car. With its footing, I would drop it. I would definitely get some wheels and tires that would fit better, all that good stuff, and from there you'll be good. I mean, that's all this car really needs. It's not a whole lot. You can do quote unquote new car problems, as I, you know, new car modification problems, as I call it, and still get away and look super nice with this. So yeah, that's pretty much it. SC430, plush interior, soft. I would say that's an upgrade from Mars in certain aspects of just, you know, door panels mainly not really flopping around and everything, and you know, dumb cup holders. It doesn't have any of that. It's got navigation, it's got a flip-up screen, and definitely customize it. And I think it has a lot to go ahead of it, because, you know, a lot of stuff to this is still kind of like 97 plus problems, to where people find the basic stuff, they throw it on when it can be so much more than what it is. But again, you know, I don't think this car has hit that sort of air or have the right owner yet to sort of breathe a fresh air of life to it. You know, the way I see things is, it's a Japanese vehicle, and just like every Japanese dish, you got to have a little bit of rice in there. All right, guys, thank you for tuning in for this video. I'm going to continue working on my audio problems. This is a voiceover directly from my phone, so stay tuned for what we have. I've ordered a new USB-C port, and that should be here. I'll install that along with my new red backing glass for my phone, and we'll see how it goes. So thank you again for tuning in. Subscribe if you like this channel. Let me know what you thought of the SC430 and what your thoughts are, along if you want to see the reupholster go down for this vehicle. Thank you, guys, and have a wonderful day.